Hi and welcome to a new video here on my YouTube channel. My name is Audrey and this is not a regular podcast episode. We are in between holidays at the end of the year and I figured it would be fun to record a little Meg 9 video presentation. So if you don't know what Meg 9 is, it is some sort of a little sharing thing that is happening on Instagram at the end of every year in the making community. People are basically selecting 9 projects that they like to do during the upcoming year and posting them on their Instagram feed. Some of them use it as a very serious challenge to sort of push them to make these projects. But overall, and for me, it's just a nice way to try and select some project that I think would be nice to put forward this year from my really long list of projects that I want to make. So this is what I try to do. I put up 9 things that I really want to make. 2 of them are actually recent things that I really fell in love with, but the other 7 are my boyfriend is currently here with me, and I told him if he wanted to come he could come here and record a video, and I don't know what he's doing, but he's on the other side of the wall and currently tapping on it. But it doesn't matter, we're going to try and do this thing anyway. Most of the projects I selected for my Make 9 are things that are on my queue for ever. And there are projects I have the yarn for, projects I really want to make, and I know I will eventually. So it was actually kind of hard to pick only 9, and I decided that I would try to make something that made sense for me, because since I will be designing quite a lot of patterns hopefully in the new year as well, I wanted to select projects that will that I am likely to be able to make and that will function as sort of breaks in between the project that I have planned design wise throughout the year. So you will see there's a selection of different things. Well, still lots of garment, still lots of color work, because this is kind of what I am into at the moment. But I selected a few different things that are hopefully going to happen in the new year. One of them is actually already started, I will get on that in a minute. But yes, like I said, I have the yarn for all 9 projects I am going to talk about, so it will be the occasion as well to showcase some of the pretty yarn I have in my stash and that has been waiting to be used for a long time. So yeah, I would like to keep this rather short so we can try and do that. I will put timestamps to all the projects, to all the 9 projects that I will share, as well as links to the patterns and to the yarn that I talk about. So if you want to have a look at that, it will be in the description just under the video. There are also links to my social media and patterns. I am pretty much Yarnflakes everywhere if you would like to see what I am up to in between videos. So yes, I think we can start, and I will insert pictures of... I'm going to try to put myself here so I can put pictures here of the projects I want to share. The first project I want to talk about for my Make 9 is the Caspian Pullover by Jared Flood / Brooklyn Tweed. Jared Flood being the founder of Brooklyn Tweed, so yeah, kind of the same thing. These are not in any particular order. I just thought they looked better in this disposition on Instagram, but yes, so the first one I want to share is the Caspian Pullover, and it's a sweater that I have seen on the Stranded podcast. Amy from the podcast started knitting it, and I think she hasn't finished it actually, because she kind of got tired of the cable at the top, and it is a Guernsey type sweater, which means that it has a cable and texture panel on the top part. And I really like these types of sweater, and it's I was looking at these and trying to find a modern version of these, something that I could wear but that has had that typical kind of separation here with the texture on the top and simple stockinette at the bottom and on the sleeve. And so I really like the Caspian for this. It is knit out of thicker yarn, which is as well something I was looking for, because I have a lot of fingering weight sweaters. I plan a lot of fingering weight sweaters for my own designs, so yeah, I kind of wanted something a little bit different. So the Caspian pullover has been on my queue for a long time. And I had the yarn, I got it, I think. I wonder if I actually didn't get it last Christmas, so that would be quite funny. I will knit mine out of Gilead. And I'm very sorry, but it is the afternoon and the sun is setting and it is cloudy, so the colors are not going to be on point. But this is the famous caramel colorway from Dererum Natura, which is the French brand of yarn. And this is their Gilead base, which is the version. It is a woolen spun, beautiful blend of French organic merino and Portuguese black merino. And it's a really, really beautiful yarn. I really like working with it. And yes, the caramel colorway is pretty famous. Everyone got a piece of it. And so I thought it would suit the Caspian pullover really well. So that's the plan. This is in my stash for a long time and it takes some space because I have like about five, because this has 250 meters to 100 grams. That is something that should be mentioned about Dererum Natura, is that since for their woolen spun basis, they have quite a generous meterage, so yeah, it is not so bad buying a sweater's quantity, even of a worsted weight. You don't end up with a ton of skeins and a really high budget. So yes, the caramel colorway of Gilead. And the second project on my Make 9 list is actually the one I already started, and I will not show too much of it because this will be for my next project focus video. If you don't know, the project focus video are a series of video I do on my YouTube channel where I share the entire process of making a thing. And it's a more vloggy type video with snippets of everything, mostly dogs and cats and food. But yeah, I wanted to make the Songbird Mittens by Erika Husser. Hope I'm not butchering that too much, but Erika Husser is known for gorgeous colorwork mittens, and I already made the Wishmaker mitts from her, which I really love, and the Songbird mittens have been on my queue as well for ever since I decided I liked colorwork mittens, which yeah, I should have done them this year because I intended to participate in knit-along for mittens, for colorwork mittens. Actually, it was Skandir's year-long knit-along where you were supposed to knit 6 pairs of mittens, of colorwork mittens. I did 3 and I just started the 4th, and it's the 29th of December, so that's a fail. But yeah, it is now part of my Make 9, and they're a beautiful pair of mittens with this really nice bird on the mitten. And I, like I said, I just started them. You will see more of these, like I said, in the dedicated project focus video. But I will just say that I am knitting them out of some drops yarn that I had in my stash. I am still trying to go through my drops stash, which is the brand I do not wish to support at all. But I do have a lot of it in my stash. And I do enjoy working with it, and Drops Flora makes a decent color work yarn. So I am using a natural color and an indigo color for these. So yeah, I am already starting one of those 9 projects, so I think we're on a good path. I can move along to the third. I'm sorry if I'm a little bit weird. Like I said, there's people around, it's the afternoon, which I'm not used to. I am very much a morning person, and basically after lunch I just become sort of a really slow, tired and a bit eerie and looking completely dead person. So I am sorry if this video is a little bit odd compared to how I usually am in my podcast. Even though I do have the impression that I say on every podcast that I apologize if I'm weird. I guess I'm just weird all the time. The third project in my Make 9 list are some socks, and they are the Clark socks, which is a pattern from J. King Salem, which is a Brooklyn knit folk. You will know her if you follow her lovely podcast here on YouTube. And these are, I believe these were her first sock pattern, and they got really popular, and for good reason. They're a pair of gorgeous cabled socks with a little bit of texture to the side, and it's a really, really nice pair of socks. And the thing is, when I saw these, I immediately knew I wanted to knit them. And so, I was browsing yarns at the same time on Etsy, and I found the perfect yarn for it, which is this beautiful, beautiful yarn. So this is a skein from Woolly Mama. I always get it wrong, that's why I checked. So this is a skein from Woolly Mama Yarns on Etsy, which is a dyer from the UK. And this is the Rusting Leaves colorway, which is really beautiful autumnal variegated yarn. And I thought it would be just perfect for the Clark socks because it kind of looks like the yarn Jacqueline used in her sample. And I'm very much an autumn shade person, so obviously I had to be a little bit of a copycat on this one. But this is a simple sock base, 75% superwash merino and 25% nylon, and it's just really interesting, and I cannot wait to cake this and see how it looks and finally turn it into the beautiful socks that I want them to be. I find it kind of hard to knit pattern socks for me at the moment because I really like designing socks, so whenever I'm knitting socks that are not simple vanilla socks to gift, it's often a design of mine, but I really need to take the time to knit other people's socks patterns because there are a lot of them that I really like and that I have on my queue. I think about half of my queue are pattern socks, the other half are sweaters, so yeah. But the Clark socks are definitely gonna get pushed to the top and hopefully they will be there soon. Let me try and do this in the right order. Yes, the next project on my Make 9 list, I actually don't have the yarn, / I have the yarn, but it is the lapwing sweater from Marie Wollin. Now, you know I really like Marie Wollin's patterns, and I have a lot of them on my queue. The thing is that they are quite intense colorwork designs, and two in particular I really want to make. But when I was thinking about my Make 9, I just thought I don't want to put pressure on myself and say I want to make a really huge 14 colors colorwork garment, because even though I think it is possible that I do at least one during the year, I thought I could try and focus on a more easy one to start with. Not in the sense easy to knit, but easy to apprehend. And that is why I chose the lapwing garment, which came out sometime last year, and I really like it. And it only has 2 colors, so that's a little bit less scary to knit. It is knit out of fingering weight yarn, and I plan to dye some yarn for this. I wasn't sure which color to do, and in the end I decided I would dye a navy blue to go with some undyed yarn I have. So I have a huge quantity of undyed yarn, so I will split it and knit part of it, dye part of it in navy blue so that I can make this sweater. And I think this will be a really fun project to do. If I am able to, I will try to share the dyeing process as well, because I think it can be quite fun seeing creation of yarn from creation to sweater. But yeah, it is a really nice sweater, and I realized recently I am lacking blue hand knits, and I really like blue, so that's a bit odd. You will see later that for some reason I'm obsessed with black and white, but yeah, I think a navy blue lapwing will happen sometime this year, and I'm really looking forward to this. I already own the pattern, so I know it's going to be a project that will require some attention, but hopefully will not be too scared to cast it on compared to one of the other massive, beautiful Murray woolen knits. That will happen, definitely. Just maybe they need to happen spontaneously so that I don't put myself in the position where I have already a lot of design in the works, and as well the pressure of casting on such a project. So yes, for the fifth project on my make night list, it is a Tenya sweater. And yes, what, Audrey, you don't have a Tenya yet? No, I don't, and I really want one, and I have the pattern and I have the yarn. I want to make my Tenya out of this yarn, which is a yarn from a French indie dyer, which is Les Vilaines, which is a play word, because laine is how we say yarn in French, and vilaine, I don't know if you're going to be able to see, yeah, basically the beginning of the word is put into parentheses. Vilaine means naughty, so that's kind of funny. And this is the colorway, a pocket full of potpourri. I have no clue if you know what potpourri is. If you don't, Google it, because it's too complicated to explain. But yeah, it's this beautiful shade of peachy, pinky, dusty, browny thing. And it's a really beautiful, nuanced color. And as a summer top, like the Tenya is, I think it would be absolutely gorgeous. I have two skeins of this, and it's a simple sock base, and I think it will look absolutely stunning. And yeah, the Tenya shouldn't take too long, right? So hopefully I will be able to make this my summer project for this year. One of my summer projects for this year. But yeah, Tenya has to happen, because I'm definitely way too late to the party, and I wanted it since I first saw it, so. Next up is, what did I write? I can't even, I am such a bad handwriter, I can't even reread myself. Yes, Parisienne, which is a pattern from Alice Summer, which is a French designer, which makes really, really interesting modern, stylish kind of pattern, especially her sweaters. And Parisienne is a really classy, simple marinière type of sweater, which with a really cool satin sleeves construction and the stripes. And it's a classic. I really love wearing marinière or any kind of stripes, really. And so it just makes sense that I knit myself. And this pattern in particular just kind of nails the whole simple but elegant aesthetic that I wanted. And I'm not going to be very original for this, because I will knit mine in black and white. Here it goes. I have some Drops Lima in my stash, which is the decay weight version of the Drops Flora. It is the same alpaca wool blend, which works pretty well for sweater. I have a sweater in Drops Lima that is holding up very well, even though it's the sweater I wear the most. And I think this combination will just work really nicely. And yeah, that is the plan. And that is the first black and white project of 2019 that I am talking about. I will talk about another one. And just so you know, I have two other plans. It's going to be a very monochrome year, I think. Duochrome, actually, but you know, black and white. Yes, now the next project on I can't count anymore. So the next project on my make nine list is a more recent pattern, and I talked about it on Instagram because when it came out I just whoa. And I think a lot of people really loved it. It's the Spectre pullover from Jorge Locatelli, and it's a beautiful, beautiful fingering weight sweater with it is Jorge works it as a fade, but she doesn't just do a fade. She made a beautiful yoke with some really nice texture stitches, and then it's reverse stockinette with slip stitch on the body, and it's really, really beautiful, and I absolutely love it. And I was desperately looking for a sweater that will accommodate a speckled yarn that I have, and it's this. This is a yarn from Knitwear, which is a UK dyer. This is her colorway Sea Spray, and it's her sock base. And I have three skeins of this beautiful cream base with lots of different kind of blue speckles. And this is absolutely stunning. And I was desperately looking for a pattern that will work with this, because I didn't want something that would just be stockinette, because that was kind of sad to do, and I already have simple stockinette sweaters. So I was kind of struggling trying to find something that would work, some texture that will still show. And this changed project quite a few times. I first wanted to make some sort of honeycomb texture, then I thought about a t-shirt. I wasn't 100% sure, but when I saw the Spectre pattern, I knew this would work really well. So mine isn't going to be a fade, but it's going to be knitted out of these absolutely stunning speckles. You have some sort of minty turquoisey blue, some more indigo ones, and yeah, I can't wait to see this because the sweater is so gorgeous. And yes, like I said, this yarn has been in my stash for quite some time, and I would hate to let it sleep there too long. So yeah, now we're coming to the end. Look at that, I'm going to be able to make quite a short video for once. The second to last sweater is the Guthrie sweater from Caitlin Hunter. So this is the second pattern from Caitlin Hunter in my make nine list. I do like Caitlin Hunter patterns, so I already made two of her designs. Is that right? Only two? Yes, only two. It's good enough. And yeah, I really like what she comes up with. I love her newest one, the Nordiska. Is it how it's written? The Nordiska pullover that she just released at the end of this year. And it's absolutely stunning. But the one I have my heart on for a while is the Guthrie pullover. So it's a colorwork, full-over colorwork sweater knit out of DK yarn. And she has two versions of the sample. She has one that is knit out of Spin Cycle yarns, I think, unless I'm saying something silly. It's more variegated yarn, and she has one that is more a contrast version in, I think her version is navy blue and white, and I really love that. I think it's just really nice, modern, cool sweater to wear, and I really want to make mine in these. So this is a natural black and white. This yarn is Pernilla by Phil Colana, which is 100% wool. And I never hear much about Phil Colana as a brand, but I think they're really nice. I have tried their Gotland yarn, and yeah, I decided to order this because I wanted to try out this quality. It's 100% wool. They said it was nice for color work and as well texture, because it still had a nice definition, and they have a really good color range. And so I just wanted to check it out, and it is super soft. I am really surprised about this. I was expecting something more on the rougher side, but no, it's really, really soft and squishy. It's also super affordable, and yeah, I know they have a really popular sock yarn as well. They have a mohair lace weight type of yarn, if that's what you're into. But I really, really like these. Yeah, so this is definitely a brand I'm going to try and turn more towards too, because like I said, it's affordable, it has great ranges of color, and as far as I know, they don't have a huge ethic problem. So yeah, they're a brand from Denmark. I know a lot of Danish designer like Petite Knit uses them. So yeah, I'm looking forward to try this yarn and to finally have my Guthrie sweater. Now, I think we're moving on to the last, yes, the last project in my Make 9 is not a project for me. And yes, that is good that I had at least one gift knit planned. And it's a sweater for my boyfriend, and it is the For Fox's Sake sweater by Maxime C. And I absolutely love it, and I am really happy because there's been a couple of recent designs that are either targeted at men or at least gender neutral, which I really, really like, because I still feel like we're really missing modern type of knitwear, modern in style for men, but that would still be fun to knit, because yeah, as much as I like knitting a full-on stockinette pullover, if I have to knit it in a yarn that's neutral enough for my boyfriend to wear it, it's not so fun. And my boyfriend is not a huge fan of cables, so there are more cable men sweaters. But yeah, besides that, I felt we were a little bit lacking. But recently there's been a couple really fun sweater designs that will totally work for my boyfriend, and For Fox's Sake is one of them, and I just find it so funny, and it is really nice as well, because it is wearable despite the really obvious foxy cheeky kind of color work that is really in your face. But I find it really fun, and I think it's one I'm going to have a really hard time parting with. I want to knit it soon. Ideally, I would like to knit it for his birthday, but yeah, it is in 1 month, so that's a little bit hard. But I do have the yarn for it already. Let me grab it. The pattern is knit out of DK weight. It calls for a gauge of 21 stitches, which I know I can achieve with Ulysse from the Rerum Natura. So it is exactly the same yarn as Gilead, which I talked about at the beginning, but it is the sport weights version. And the thing with Ulysse is that it's wool and spun, and it's really versatile in terms of gauges, so I know I will absolutely get the 21 stitch gauge with this. And I was really happy to be able to find colors that matched the pattern sample, because original Audrey strikes again. I just copied the pattern sample because I just thought the color combination was really good and my boyfriend liked it too, so I know this will work. I will be using the color Granite, Baleine Bleu, which is Blue Whale, this is Doré, Golden, and this is Sel, Salt, which is the undyed cream version. And yes, the main color will be the gray, and then the yoke will be these three, which is really nice. And yeah, I really can't wait to work on this. Like I said, I think I'm gonna have some difficulties parting with it, because I find the sweater so funny and so beautiful. But yeah, I hope my boyfriend will like it. I think it will suit him. He absolutely loves yellow, so I know this pop of color would be nice. I've also made sure to get shades that I will be able to reuse in case I have some leftover. So yes, this looks really fun to knit. There's a couple testers version that are really beautiful as well, and yeah, it's nice. I think we might see that on my needle rather soon. Even though it is the last project I share, I think it's probably going to be one of the first I actually make. And with this, I think I have successfully shared my Make 9 projects with you. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little video. It's like a little impromptu thing quickly filmed in the middle of the holidays. And yeah, I hope you're having a lovely time and that you are looking forward to getting into the new year, that you are, if you are as well, sort of planning a Make 9 for 2019, that you are excited for the projects that you can make. So yeah, these were my plans for personal projects of 2019, and I do not know yet when I will return with a regular podcast episode. You will be kept up to date on Instagram about that, but yes, I am still going to be on sort of a holiday break for the next couple of weeks. So there's that. I hope you are having a lovely time, and I will see you next time. Bye!